Scrappy knit cardigan. It is all patchy and seamed up the sides and down the sleeve, and it's a super quick and super easy make. If you are looking to make your first garment, this might be the one to try. I've had people say that this is like the Harry Styles cardigan, which that's pretty cool. But yeah, I just had some scraps that I used up and did these patchworks. So I did try to make one where I make all the squares and then sew it together, but oh, I hit my camera. It looked like this. And I thought I would have all this like textured squares and really mix it up, but when I seamed it together, it was so bulky, so I hated it. And I really liked the concept though. So then I thought, well, and you can kind of see it's like lumpy. So anyway, I really liked it, but I wanted to make it without having to seam all the squares because that was also a lot of work. So for this one, I still have to seam all the, or sorry, I have to tie up all the ends, but this one is not lumpy at all. It's super seamless. What I did is I had four colors going at once and I just knit across, changing to the next color as it went. So my squares are 12 stitches and 14 rows. And then the trick is when you pick up like the next color, you just wrap the working yarn around the first stitch of the next color, and then that just creates this seam inside. So you can kind of see it there. It's like already seamed for us just because I wrapped that yarn around the working yarn of the next stitch. So it's worked out really well. And so I did that up the back, and I did four squares on the back. So 12, that was 48 stitches wide, and then 14 stitches per color, 14 rows per color. So I got to about 22 and a half inches on the back, and then I just stopped wrapping the yarn on the two middle colors and I kept going with the sides. So then I kind of went up the back and then I just split the front and I kept going down the two front panels, and it's still all seamless. And then when I had the desired length for that, so it would match my back, then I worked on the sleeves. I cast on about 30 stitches, and then I did an increase every 8 rows on the sleeves. And then I kept the pattern the same with 14 rows per color, which I could have adjusted because I did end up with this tiny little strip here because I wanted that extra length. So better planning next time, but that's okay. It doesn't bother me that much. Once I had the sleeves, then I laid it out flat and I seamed, found the top of the shoulder and the middle of the sleeve, and then I pinned that on and seamed it together. Once that was on, double check, try it on. I like the sleeve length. I could continue. So then I went and I seamed up the side and down the side of the sleeve. And then that was that. And like, you can barely tell that that's a seam. It's unfortunate that those two squares match colors. I was trying to really spread it out, but I only had, I think, 8 colors. So it was hard to spread them out. And then just the finishing touch is the collar. I think it makes it look really finished. And it's another little pop of color that I liked. So it's a fun project, and it was really fast. I used 9mm knitting needle size for the ribbing. That's a US 13, and then the 10mm or US 15 knitting needle for the body. And I hope you want to make one. I hope you enjoy this project. It's fun and quick, and you can do so many different color combos, so I really want to see them all. Please tag me on Instagram if you use Instagram, or email them to me, whatever you want to do. I would love to see your project. I made this in like 10 days and I was busy doing other mom stuff too, so it's a pretty quick project. So I will stop talking about it and show you how to make it. Okay, we actually have to do a couple things before we just start making it, which is we need to get the measurements. So mine, eating my hair, my sweater is a drop shoulder. Like, this is almost at my elbows. I wanted something nice and wide. So what I did is I just took my measuring tape and I just kind of went, took the tape measure and measured across my shoulders like this to get just an idea of width. And then once I knew what my width was, I could check my gauge. So because I had already made this, I've done half the work, but I have a ton of little gauge swatches here basically. So I measured across. This should be done while laying flat. Okay, so when you're taking a gauge, usually you want to do it over the 4 inches, and you can see here I have 8 stitches-ish, and this is nice and flat because this is kind of bulky, 8 stitches in this 4-inch window here. So then divide that by 4 and it's 2 stitches per inch. So then I wanted my sweater to measure around 22-24 inches because this is all blocked, so I knew it was going to stretch out, and I decided to go with 48 stitches. So 48 stitches wide with 2 stitches per inch is going to measure around 24 inches. Okay. So I would say that's like a small, medium size. Here is what you're going to need to make your own cardigan. And we have the gauge down here again for you. So make sure that you take the time to do up a little 4x4 square and make sure that you're meeting the gauge. And here's the sizing options. So once you've done your gauge and you can double check that you're meeting it, so 2 stitches per inch, you can pick your size and we can get started. So with the 9mm or US 13 knitting needles and your chosen color for the ribbing, cast on 48 stitches for small medium size. For large XL, cast on 56. For double XL, triple XL, cast on 64. For 4 and 5 XL, cast on 72, using your preferred cast on technique. Here I am using the long tail cast on method. Once I have my desired amount of stitches cast on, I can start the ribbing section, which is just a knit 1, purl 1 across. Continue knitting rows of knit 1 and purl 1 until you reach approximately 2.5 inches long. For my sample, it took about 7 rows to get to 2.5 inches. Now that the ribbing section is done, we're going to change our knitting needles from the 9mm or US 13 to a 10mm or US 15 for the main body of the project. I like using these interchangeable needles and cables. They're from Chiagu. Pick out your 4 colors and start knitting across. 12 stitches per color for small medium, 14 for large XL, and 16 for double and triple XL, 18 for 4 and 5 XL. I changed out my colors just so that I wasn't using the same yellow as my ribbing. I knit and purled a row here already. When you change the color, wrap the 2 colors, working yarns, together to avoid a hole in your work. When you drop the first color, drop it on top of the next color yarn you will be using. So I'm dropping the last color on top of the next color's working yarn.
This is twisting the yarn together, seaming our patches for us, and avoiding any holes in the work. So here I am picking out my next colors for the next color block, trying to keep the colors spread out as best I can. To start the next color block, cut a long tail 6 to 8 inches on all of your colors and start knitting your next color blocks. Same as the first row after the ribbing, you will need to knit one in the new color, then wrap the last color around to twist the yarn and avoid any holes in the work. Do not forget this step. It saves you time later instead of having to seam up all these extra holes. Here's another clip, wrapping the yarn after making one stitch or twisting the yarn around just so that it's really, really clear. Here's the back side of our work. You can see the seams are already done for us with the yarn wrapping technique. They're not bulky at all, and they look really neat and tidy. Continue with the pattern, switching colors when needed until your back panel reaches the desired length. Okay, I've reached my desired length, which was around 22 and a half inches, and I decided to split through this square. So I've done 7 here, and then now for the next 7 of this color section, I'm just not going to join the 2 in the middle and continue working the 2 sides separately. So the purple, burgundy color or whatever, and the blue color, I'm just not going to keep wrapping them, and that'll split the 2 panels, and I'll just continue working both sides. So on the back side, I've wrapped the first 2 squares. And then now I'm going to stop wrapping these 2 middle ones and just let them fall. And continue with the exact same pattern, same thing, except for joining the 2 colors in the middle. Until I get the same length on the front. I have finished knitting the front of my sweater, my panels. I did both panels at the same time, just going back and forth, working with the 4 colors again. And I am down to the end here where I'm just gonna add the yellow back on and do the ribbing. I'm gonna change back onto the 9mm needles and finish that up, and then I can move on to the sleeves. So this is all still gonna line up along the edges here and the middle, or the shoulder there is kind of, it's gonna be right through the middle like that. Here is a sleeve. What I did was cast on 30 stitches with the 9mm needles, and I did 7 rows of ribbing, so knit 1, purl 1, and then I did the same amount of rows in the colors as the body of the sweater, so 14 rows per color, and then I kind of got to the length that I think that I want, so I'll just end it there. With the cast on, there's 30 stitches, and then every 8 rows, there's an increase. There's a knit one, and then an increase on this end, knit across, and an increase, and knit the last stitch. And my increase I like to do is just make one left, make one right, which I can show you how to do. So we're gonna knit one. And then we're gonna grab this bar right here in between the stitches. So you can use your right needle to pick it up and put it on your left needle from the front, or since this is kind of spread out and thicker yarn, you probably can get your left needle to pick it up from the back. And then you're going to knit that stitch. And then now you've made an extra stitch. So it's called make one right, make one R, M1R, because it is going to increase this direction. And then we are going to knit across, and at the when we have one stitch left on our needles, that is when we're going to make a make one left, or M1L. Okay, so we're on our last stitch on the needle here. Whoop, don't do that. Don't drop your needle. Okay, so now we're going to grab that bar again from the middle, and this time the left needle is going to go from the front to back while picking it up. And with this knit stitch, I like to go in through the back. So knit it through the back loop. And there we are. We have our increased stitch. And that is the make one left, because it's going to go to the left. So for the sleeve, we're going to do that increase row every 8 rows, and we're going to change color every 14 rows. As long as you are doing the increase rows, you can change colors whenever you want, but just keep track of your increase rows, and then you'll be golden. Alrighty, I've got my pieces all done. So here is the front. It's just kind of curled up a little bit. That's okay. And then I have two sleeves. One and two. So I think I was going to do that one over there. That one over there. I'll just zoom you out a little bit. You can see the ugly box sides, but that's okay. So I'm gonna do something like that, and then I'm gonna add the color. So basically this sleeve is 22. Sorry, no, it is 42 stitches long. The cast off edge, so 21 stitches per side of this stitch marker that I went ahead and marked the halfway of here, which is the top of the shoulder, and that is going to put us to about here. So we're going to use some stitch markers just to hold the sleeve in place where we want it. Find the middle. 42 stitches means 21 stitches per side. You want to take an extra care lining up your seams at this stage in the game, because it will set you up for the seams that you do along the side, and the more time and more careful you are, the better it'll look. Even though seaming is not the funnest part of any project, in my opinion, but whatever. You want to make sure you find your middle part in your sleeve here, and the middle part at the top of the shoulder here, and then you start working your way down, matching how many stitches for how many rows, and line those up. So I know I have 7 on the yellow side there. I've got an extra long needle with the large eye on there. I couldn't find my shorter needles, but it doesn't really matter. So it's nice and thick, easy to get through the thicker stitches, and it's got a nice thick eye. When I did my sleeves, I made a nice long tail. I don't know if this tail is actually long enough, but we're gonna
try it out. And we're just gonna turn our work here. So I'm attaching my sleeve here. I'm going to find the bars in between the stitch, the very last stitch of this row, and these bars all through here. I'm going to be grabbing those on that side, and then I'm going to be grabbing the entire stitch going through both loops on this side. So we will start over here. Picking up the stitch, both bars. Probably get rid of this stitch marker. So now I've got my spot that's just in the way. And then you just work your way up. Grab the next bar up and the next stitch over here. And just keep going. Okay, so now we are all got the seams seamed up. Have a look. What size? There's our seam. Side. Armpit. And we want to make sure, especially with stripes, that the stitches line up perfectly. And then you will barely be able to even tell that there is a seam. So you're going to do the exact same thing, except now that you're joining two panels where the stitches are going the same way, you're just going to be grabbing those bars in between on the one side and the bars in between on the other side, and just working your way up. When you get to the armpit, nothing tricky there. You literally just turn and go down. So you want to make sure you have a nice long string for seaming all that in.
So here is my side seam. You can barely tell this is a seam at all. All the stripes are lining up perfectly, so it's looking really, really good. I went in down at the bottom here, do the ribbing and working my way up, and I'm now at the armpit. So I just need to do the last couple stitches and tuck in all the extra strings, line it up, and work my way down the sleeve. So on the sleeve, I just need to pick the line that is going to be one stitch in. It's a little bit tricky because we have increased stitches, but just do your best to pick that outside stitch and go grab that bar in between. And work your way all the way down to the cuff, and that's it.
All right, I have my sleeves seamed on, got the sides done, other side done, there's the seam. It's pretty good, I can barely tell. There's the seam on the sleeve down, so there we go. Now it just looks a little unfinished. Obviously, because we have all these ends to weave in. Oh my gosh. But we are going to add a collar. And I'm going to use pink. So I made my needle cord extra long. I attached two different cords using extenders, and I've got 10 mil, which should be 9 mil.
For the collar,
we need to go back onto the 9mm needles, and we need to go around the opening of the sweater and pick up the stitches. The collar will be a knit one, purl one, just like the ribbing on the bottom of the cardigan. I decided to use my pink yarn, and I'm going to start at the bottom of the opening at the yellow ribbing, and just like seaming, pick up stitches in between the bars, between the last stitch and the next stitch, and then just keep the same line the whole way around. Here's just a closer look at what I'm doing here. So again, like the seaming process, pick up your stitches through the bars between the last stitch and the next. This is going to be the last step before we can start knotting and weaving in all the ends. And then we're going to be done.
Alrighty, I have finished my collar around the sweater here. I ended up doing 7 rows, knit one, purl one, and then I just bound it off, and it's looking really good. Sorry, I can't get the whole thing in the shot, but so I still have the ends in here to weave in. I did a couple already just because I wanted to take some photos, but yeah, all you're doing is tie it. You can weave in the ends a little bit or just trim off the edges, and that's it. You're done. Yay!